One of the key new features with DM3 version 2 is the ability to use the USB port for inserts, input and output channels, pre or post fader. Use it on up to 18 channels. Or split the USB port into 4 virtual devices, allowing the computer to run multiple applications with different audio channels. So you can add inserts to some channels, run a teleconference and a live stream all at once. Let me show you how to set it up using VST Rack Elements. Each DM3 comes with a download access code for both Cubase AI and VST Rack Elements, so you can use this to get started. It includes 6 Steinberg plugins as standard, to which you can add a huge range of VST plugins from other sources. I love the Yamaha plugins that are included with VST Rack Pro and the RU-IO 16D. If you have them, they can also be used with the DM3. Before we go further, let's check if the console has been upgraded. Open the setup menu and touch About. If it's not version 2, grab the upgrade from Yamaha's website and copy it onto a USB drive. Once V2 is installed, open the setup menu and activate the inserts. This can act as a safety bypass in case of computer trouble. Then select the new USB driver mode in the preference menu, USB. Mode 1 is the default with 18 in and out ports for one USB driver. Mode 2 splits the USB port into 4 virtual devices, 3 stereo and 1 12-channel device, so it can be used with 4 different software applications at the same time. So let's select Mode 2 and allow the console to reboot after touching Apply. Connect a computer via USB and see how it looks. Of course, you'll need to update the driver first, whether it's Windows or Mac OS. Then you'll be able to see the 4 virtual devices. Yamaha DM3 DAW, which uses USB channels 1 to 12, and 3 stereo devices using USB channels 13 to 18. After opening VST Rack, go to the hardware settings and select Yamaha DM3 DAW as the audio device. With Mac OS, you will see a high precision option that supports 32-bit float. It doesn't matter with DM3, though note that high precision is required when using VST Rack with the RU-IO 16D to make use of its integral bypass switch, for example. Create a new project at the top of the screen, and in the main window, you will see USB 1 to 12 has been assigned to channels 1 to 12. Though we haven't patched any inserts on the DM3 yet, so let's do that. Let's use inserts on input channels 1 to 8, the main stereo channel, and matrix 1 and 2. Select input channel 1 first and look at the home screen, then touch the insert box. Select the insert out patch to be USB 1 and do the same for the insert in patch. Then select the insert point. Pre-fader is a good place to insert dynamics processors like compression. Then enable the insert by touching the insert label so it turns green. And now do the same for input channels 2 to 8. And use this scroll shortcut to quickly patch adjacent channels. For the main stereo channel, there are insert patches for the left and right sides. Notice the insert point cannot be post-fader, though. But that's okay. If I wanted post-fader processing, I could just send the channel out via USB without an insert. If I use USB 9 and 10 as inserts for the stereo channel, I can pair racks 9 and 10 in VST Rack. That'll make sure I use stereo versions of the plugins. Let's use USB 11 and 12 for matrix 1 and 2. We could insert additional EQ for output processing and add a maximizer to use as live stream dynamics processing and limiting. We should find that the audio signal flow is working well. But let's make that insert active safety switch more accessible. We can assign it to a user-defined key. Open the Setup menu and User-Defined Keys menu. Select one of the six keys and scroll through the function list to find Insert. Then choose Insert Active as parameter 1 and touch OK. Now that key is ready to use as a safety bypass with a confirmation message to avoid unintended deactivation. When the inserts are not active, yet are switched on, you will notice their indicators flash. That is a helpful warning. Now that's all set up, you are free to route the main stereo outputs or the matrix outputs to USB channels 13 and 14, 15 and 16, or 17 and 18 for use with conferencing or streaming software, making use of the additional virtual USB devices available with DM3 version 2. Achieve that as usual in the patch menu, where you can also see the new insert patches. For each software application running on your computer, select the appropriate virtual USB audio device to provide sound in and out via the DM3. It's possible to have a teleconference running with one virtual device, mix the remote audio with local inputs, and stream the result out to another platform using one of the other virtual sound devices. Interfacing DM3 with computer software has just got a whole lot more versatile. And if you have the DM3 with Dante, you can even run inserts through the Dante network, where the possibilities are on a whole other level of vast. Don't miss the other video about what's new with DM3 version 2. And I hope you have time to upgrade before your next project starts. See you soon.